Hey guys, Jarek here, and welcome to Amberscape. And today we are going to do a fossil preparation video. The fossils are gonna be mostly corals from the Silurian and Ordovic time epochs, and the preparation gonna be done with the vinegar. And I was waiting for this day for quite a long time because I needed to have enough corals for this video. And basically all these corals are from this season. I was looking and hunting for them this whole summer. So let's go and check them out. Okay, I'm ready. All the pieces are here that I wanted to treat. And on the second thought, not all of them will go into vinegar. Pieces like this one, not gonna go into vinegar because there will be nothing left of them for sure, but I have another trick in my sleeve. What can I do with them? Yeah, and these amazing corals. I hope at least one survives. If not, then basically the whole season of coral hunting is gonna go to vain and I'm gonna be a very sad boy. So yeah, we are gonna do this prep with vinegar. And I have 5 bottles of vinegar. They are 9% spirit vinegar compound, so it shouldn't be too strong, it shouldn't be too weak. If it's gonna be too strong, then I will be using some water to make the solution a little bit weaker. And we're gonna place all of these things in here, so in this blue box. And I'm not gonna keep this box inside for the process because it stinks as hell. So let's go and fill it up.
Even at this early stage of the vinegar prep, when I opened the bottle and started pouring the first drops of the vinegar into my corals, I was starting to getting very worried, because I wanted to for these corals to survive. I was saying that I want at least one survive, but deep down I wanted all of them to survive the prep and to look amazing afterwards. Depending on location where the fossil was found, it contains different amounts of calcium, and the calcium dissolves in the vinegar very easily. And historically, at my location, all the corals contains at least some of the calcium. The more the calcium, the bigger the risk.
Oh wow, and the reaction is very strong. As you can see, I have some still corals on the table because not all of them fitted inside. But I will be removing them periodically and inserting new ones. And I need to keep my eyes open for this because the reaction is crazy strong with these ones. I'm back and this is very short update. Only 15 minutes has passed and look guys what is happening. Just 15 minutes, keep in mind.
The water is looking like this, it is empty, I removed all the corals and the vinegar looks like someone died in there and is decomposing. Okay, let's check the corals. So there is some good news and bad news. The good news is this coral. The patterns are getting very pretty, guys. I think this one might survive, but it's still too early to say. Just 15 minutes, keep in mind. And all the changes, like this one also. It became very white and the patterns have merged even more, so this one is like looks really promising also. And I think it might have some other fossils in here also. And I should be very careful because it's breaking my hand. Like for example this coral, it did get a lot of patterns but is being devoured. So I will remove it from it. The inside combs look very interesting, but yeah, this one will get eaten absolutely. It looks a lot more like coral now, but I will remove it from vinegar. All of the syringopores are getting destroyed also. And one of them is quite nice. This one when wet, there are crinoids everywhere from the other side, I wasn't seeing them before. And also this one, favocytes are also turning out to be very nice after a little while in the vinegar.
Okay, so I'm putting almost everything back except for the syringoporus, and this chain coral, it's getting eaten out. It's very sad, but I will put it back just to see what's left of it. Okay, time to get everything back into the vinegar. And so the corals are still dissolving in the vinegar, and meanwhile it's happening, let's treat our other corals with some magic, and the magic is nail polish. And you will see why we'll use it. There's few reasons. First of all, they will always look wet, and when they are wet they look a lot better. And the second reason, for in the case of crinoids, because I did already retrieve one of them, I don't want to dissolve this baby any longer, and it will make it a little bit harder to break, because right now these chains are very they're easy breaking. They are easy to break. So let's see this coral how it looks like. It's still wet, so there is won't be that much effect. I will wait for it to dry out and then I will polish it. And now let's just polish these rocks and see how it looks like. And I wanted to start from this piece. This is also a chain coral. It's called Cenotypora extilis, and it's quite a rare species of the chain coral. Right now it doesn't look very nice, right? Even though it is. You see, these patterns are very interesting. And let's see what will happen when we will polish it.
In this matrix there is tons of crinoids, and they are getting alive when getting nail polished treatment. And because I wasn't doing the best job with the nail polish, I asked my curly girl to help me with that, because she's definitely have more experience dealing with it.
These are the results, guys, and miracles sometimes happen, because most of the corals, the big ones, the chain corals, survived. Like the worst of them, of the bigger ones, was this piece. And why I'm saying that it's the worst one? Because it was dissolving, after all. As you see, the chains are not sticking out of the matrix, and the piece is considerably smaller now. So when the matrix was dissolving, then the chain itself was dissolving, so I just removed it. And the best one by far is this one. This one is a beauty. The color is magnificent. And let's not take too much time, I will show you all of them. These patterns on this one is the most prominent ones. Like, it looks crazy good, and when I think about it, what does it resembles when you look at that? For me, it does resemble neuron connections in the brains. And that's the patterns how the chain coral is growing. Okay, and the last one. This one.
also a beauty. This one is very nice from the sides, because you can see the structure of the chains better here. And I did left some matrix for two reasons. The first one, it's a lot safer to have matrix in here, because without matrix the chain coral is very fragile. And the other one is I didn't want to keep it too long in the vinegar, because it's start dissolving. And these smaller pieces together, in my opinion, can make a nice interior, like part of the interior at least. Like you can put it somewhere in the house and it won't even look half bad. Yeah, this looks very nice. I will put them somewhere, maybe in the bathroom, who knows. Yeah. And I will show also the stinkers, guys. This is the Syringapora. It was dissolving very badly. That means there was a lot of calcium in this one, and I wasn't even keeping it in the vinegar too long. And this is the smallest chain coral. It was also eaten out very badly. It's crumbling in my hands even now without saving it. Like, there is nothing you can do. If it's dissolving, it's dissolving. End of the game. And the biggest ones haven't changed a lot. There are nice corals for visitas, but you know, compared to the chain corals, nothing special. And that's the sun coral, and yeah, that should be enough for this video, guys. So I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, consider subscribing and liking this video, and see you next time. Bye.